Hello, family. I woke up healthy and happy. I'm excited to be here to read out your comments and to inform you and make you happy. The Joy FM Beauty and Bridal Fair is opening today, and I'm thrilled because it will present a lot of items. It's an opportunity for me to go out there, see what's on sale, how I can get them, what they can be used for. And all of those who are preparing to get married in years to come or in months to come, from stands at the Accra International Conference Center. So my name is Ms. G. I'm the Entertainment General. You're live on the Joy News channel on Multi TV, DSTV channel 421, Go TV channel 144. Join us on Facebook and Twitter. The handle is Joy News on TV. All right, so like I said to you in my introduction, the Joy FM Beauty and Bridal Fair opens today. It's live at the Accra International Conference Center. Those who want to get married. So in the spirit of weddings, brides, and everything beautiful, I want to usher you to this year's Joy FM Beauty and Bridal Fair, which is live at the Accra International Conference Center. We'll cross over shortly. You can see shots from the Accra International Conference Center. You need to be there. It's starting today, ends on July 2nd, and it's a lot of fun for those who want to get married. But let's see this bride, who is a very beautiful bride, preparing to get married. All right, we'll see that later, but still visuals from the Accra International Conference Center. Some people call it the Pink Lady, and we'll be there. Items will be up on sale for those who want to get married. Those who are preparing, there'll be people to teach you or take you through the process of preparing to get married. There'll be counseling sessions for people who are already married. So it's a packed four-day event at the Accra International Conference Center. Don't miss out. Now, back here in the studio, the National Science and Maths Quiz is keeping hit, and it's hit. The trend is still on. People are talking about it, and it's no surprise because the time has come. Today is that big day where three schools would get to compete for the ultimate award. Now, Prempeh College, Adisodel College, and St. Thomas Aquinas battle in a fierce to win the title this year. Now, the National Science and Maths Quiz is a big deal, but this year is rather on another level. All students are on top of affairs, cheering their schools to victory, especially on social media. So, if we are asking you this morning, who gets to win the Science and Maths Quiz 2017. I'm sure if you're an old student of Prempeh College, you'll be very glad that your school wins. I've seen my own colleague here, Ridwan Ibrahim Asante, who is from Adisodel, an old student of Adisodel College, clothed in his old school uniform, and he says that he didn't bring a car to work. And what's going to happen is that if Adisodel doesn't win, he gets to walk home. So that's how some people who are old students are actually, you know, rallying behind their schools. I don't know of St. Thomas Aquinas, but I know that the old students and their girls, there's the girls from Accra Girls, are rallying behind their boys. Those are their boys. So let's see how it pans out. By 1 p.m., we definitely will know who becomes winner for this year's edition of the National Science and Maths Quiz 2017. And I can't wait to see the winner. Because after that, we know that later in the year we'll have the school's reunion put together by Joy FM, and I know that the school that gets the win will come parading all over the place and have the bragging rights. They can tell you that they are the school that have won. So Prempeh College, Adisodel College, and St. Thomas Aquinas are up for this year's finals, the National Maths and Science Quiz. Let's go straight to Facebook now to read your comments. What have you been saying? Okay. All right. So, Joy FM, why don't you show the program? Okay. And we definitely will bring you the results. And you want to say that vetting is not of national interest? Are you sure? and Fawson says, I hope you show it live. And I'll be so disappointed if none of the TV stations show it, okay? And my heart goes out for Adisco. It was my dream school during my teenage days, but it never materialized. All the same, black and white for life. And Nantamba says, it's clear Adisco won even before the competition started, and Prempeh College is definitely winning the trophy. Prempeh all the way is his hashtag, and Prempeh College, the blood is green. We are taking over today by all means possible. Amount for and Prempeh College 56, Adisco 50, St. Thomas Aquinas 47. You have put out some scores that you believe would turn out today as the event is underway at Prempeh College. Isha Allah says Allah Hassan, and Michael says Prempeh College will surely win the 2017 science and maths quiz, and come what may, you added. And Prempeh College says Sana Muhammad, and Junior says Prempeh College all the way, no two sides. And Kute says, I love Aquinas, we are taking the cup. St. Thomas Aquinas Senior High School. Brown says Prempeh College all the way. Prempeh College from Nana Owusu-Aw. Prempeh College from Kwabena Boateng. But the trophy will stay at Cantonment though. And Cantonment, definitely, that's where St. Thomas Aquinas is located. And Prempeh is winning one touch. Agbina. That's from Godfred. And Atariku says, they're old terms, go Aquinas, or go Aquinas. And Prempeh, the blood is still working, amount for. And Zachary says, Aquinas, the best Q and poor students in school, says question. I'm sure your school is not participating, so that's how you react. But hail Adisco all the way. I wish them all the best of luck. Please, the update, that's from Mary Pukua. So by 1 p.m., we get to know who wins this year's National Maths and Science Quiz. And Edubotre is asking, he says, okay, Adisco is in a comfortable lead. Aquinas win, amount for all the way. And what happened? Take give Prempeh. You are saying that it should be given to Prempeh College. That's from Amas. It says Amas Phobia. The Adisco for real. And good luck. And you're saying to them is going to be okay. So comments from you concerning this year's maths and science quiz, which is happening today. But once more, we'll cross over to the Accra International Conference Center, where my colleague Hannah Odami is standing by to fill us in on what exactly is happening as the fair opens today. So if we can speak to you, Hannah. Hello, Hannah.
So from the 29th of June to the 2nd of July, the Accra International Conference Center is the place to be. Why? Because the Joy FM Beauty and Bridal Fair is ongoing, fast and thick. This is the place to be for will-be couples. Because you have all the gowns, the tuxedos, the shoes, the heels, the gowns. In fact, the jewelries, I've seen some beautiful jewelries from Nazarene Jewelries. There's also the makeup that will make you sparkle. Well, don't forget that after the wedding, some couples make babies so quickly. And so there are some baby products here as well. In fact, on the night of the honeymoon, you'll have to get to the hotel. And so there are a lot of hostel destinations here. And you wouldn't want to forget about that particular moments that you were having, making the love. And so there's photography all over here. You'll have so many to choose from. You know, I have with me Fascinita. This is the thing to have on now. And it's coming from one of our exhibitors, Hattix Kukua here is going to tell us how Fascinitas are going to catch on for the bride, for the mother-in-law, for the groom's mom, the mother of the bride. In fact, all the witnesses coming to the wedding, this is the thing to have on today. Kukua, what's your expectation for bridal fair this year?
My expectation for the bridal fair, well, actually, because of the first lady's, the second lady rather, should I say, the second lady's use of Fascinator just a few months ago, it suddenly caught on, but then Fascinators have been around for a while. And last 2 years we exhibited, we were here, but then it was good. The sales were good. But then after the use of the fascinator by the second lady, it suddenly caught on. It did.
And I'm sure sales is booming.
It is. And then we're expecting that by the end of the fair, would be glad, would be just happy we came to the Joy Bridal Fair as exhibitors.
Yeah. So we are expecting that you'll run out of stock here.
And because every bride to get some more and restock.
Yes. So mother-in-laws, all the brides, this is the thing. You'll have to, there are so many colors here. And I'm sure you love mine as well. Let's move on and get to some other exhibitors who are still putting up. And I have with me here my sister. How are you? She's with Nazarene Jewelries, and as I told you earlier, they have some wonderful stuff here. You can see that construction is still ongoing. They are trying to put things together, but she's going to tell me something later. Now, what's your expectation for this year?
We are hoping for the best. We are hoping for the best. That's okay. What the year is.
In terms of sales?
Yes.
Are there new types of jewelries you have brought that will catch on?
Yes. We brought nice designs, and we've added 22 carat to our rings. We've added rose gold to our stuffs.
So can you show me some of your new designs? I'm told you have 22 carats extra.
Yes, it's extra.
It's here. So let's move on and see what we have new.
These are
22 carats. 22, wow. Well, a camera can't fit in there, but I can see it's sparkling. Well, I may have to probably change mine because this is sparkling. And this is Nazarene Jewelry. They are still trying to put bits and pieces together. Let's move on to a hotel destination, Alisa Hotel. You can see that after the wedding, you'll be exhausted. You'll be exhausted. And you'll have to go get some rest. Unfortunately, there's a, hi, my lady. How you doing? She's still putting the towels and beds together. Well, after the wedding, I get to sit on the bed. How are you? So, do you have any special package for couples after the wedding?
Yes, please.
Okay, so tell us about it.
We have fruits for them.
Fruits?
Yes.
Specific fruits?
Different kinds of fruits.
Do you have the coconut?
That's yes,
the
please. Have.
Okay, so can you look at my camera? All right, tell us what you have.
We have the fruits, fruit platter. Yes, okay. Please. We have fruit platter for them. We have a surprise dinner for them.
Is it part of the package or is free?
It's part of the package.
Okay.
Yes.
Is it at a specific location in the hotel?
Yes, please.
Okay.
At the restaurant.
Is there any discounts for those who will be coming to the bridal fair?
Yes, please.
Great. So you all out there, you have to come to the stand of Alisa Hotel because there is some special discount package for you. What more do you have with regards to Alisa? Because this is the setup we'll see when you come to your hotel.
Yes,
all right. How many days? Will it be just a weekend?
Just the weekend. 3 days from Saturday, Sunday. You can even stay there the number of days you want to stay.
But will it all come with a discount? That's what we
yes,
all want.
Please. It will come with a discount.
Great. And so this is the stand of Alisa Hotel. They are offering special packages for every one of you would-be couples that will come to their stand here. And they have the brochure. You have the voucher here to give out. You can see they are laying the bed. Isn't this nice? Just come around. Just come around if you are a couple to be. Now, you'll also need to get some cards. And so let's move on to the cards and favors. Hello. How are you all? You're live on Joy News. How are you? Okay, so she's going to tell us about the cards.
Okay.
Once you're going to organize your wedding, let's move a bit forward. Once you're going to organize your wedding, there are special kinds of cards. Oh, there are special kinds of cards that you will want to give out. You want to be out of the ordinary, you know. Everyone has their square card that we all send around. Mr. and Mrs. The family of this invites you to this particular wedding. But I see that they have special designs here. These are some of the souvenirs that we'll be giving out. And I have with me here my lady to tell us more about her stand. Now you tell me, what's the name of your shop? Elegant Cards.
Yes, as the name implies, Elegant Cards and Favors.
Favors.
Yes.
Tell us more of what you do and what you'll be doing for our would-be couples.
Okay. What we do is event stationery, customized or tailored to suit the client's events.
And then for the would-be couple coming, we are going to give them something unique. In fact, it's actually a surprise, so we wouldn't say it. When they come, they will know what they are getting, yes.
Just something?
Something unique. We have favors for any occasion.
But so you have to give us a gist to
of what they are getting.
Yes, so that at least it will draw traffic to your stand.
Oh, okay, they are getting favors. I mean, something like this.
Okay.
They are going to get something like
this. Can you open it for us to see what's in there?
It's a beautiful fan.
Oh, wow, as a souvenir.
As a souvenir.
For everyone that will
for
present a gift.
For everyone who would come to the event.
Okay, and so let's look at this. There you go.
Is it not beautiful?
I can open this.
Let me help you.
Okay. Wow, like so you get to have this at Elegant Cards and Flavors. When you get, you present it to everyone that gives you a gift. I think some people may not be able to present you a gift, and so you have to give it out for free. How about that?
Ha! Nothing for free.
Ah, well, but then you have some discounts.
Definitely.
Okay. And so,
we actually do in say. Okay. Yes.
Show me some of your unique cards that the couple-to-be will send out to their invitees.
Sure.
So let's get into the shop. Let's get into the shop. Well, I like this particular one because it's a scroll invite. Open it and let's have a look at it.
Like this.
Yes.
Very interesting concept.
All of this makes you understand that the Joy FM Beauty and Bridal Fair is a place to be from the 29th of June to the 2nd of July. There's no other place to get all your one-in-all shop, everything that you need for your wedding. It's here at the Joy FM Beauty and Bridal Fair. So be fast and come to the Accra International Conference Center. Now, for you who have not yet designed your invitation cards, there's a scroll invite here.
With the corners laser cut.
Oh my, with the what?
Laser cuts at the corners, beautifully laid out.
It's just unique. It's just unique. This is something so different, something so different. It's not like the normal card that we all use, you know, and so this is something different. You may want to come to this particular shop for more designs. I can see a lot of them here. There are more designs. So thank you very much. We wish you all the best. I talked to you about jewelries. Perhaps we may want to do, let's get to a makeup shop because, you know, that's one of the best things that a bride, particularly, we want to see when she's having her big day, the makeup. So let's move on to the makeup. Please, we are coming live, okay?
And those are shots from the Accra International Conference Center, where we have the Beauty and Bridal Fair 2017 starting. And my colleague Hannah Odami brought you stories or beautiful stuff for your wedding from stands available at the Accra International Conference Center. But we're taking a break. Definitely we'll be back with more here on Joy News Interactive. Please stay. Right, that's a very beautiful video. It's every mother's joy to see her daughter walk down the aisle. And this is the bride who's walking down the aisle and singing as she walks to the altar to meet her husband. Now, Parliament is talking about a rather worrying issue. Members of Parliament are concerned about the rate at which teachers impregnate their students. Yes. members of parliament say that they are worried about the situation because it's contributing to a high dropout rate among girls and threatening their future. Some of the MPs expressed their concern on the floor of parliament on Wednesday. So on Joiners Interactive, we asked, why do some teachers engage in sexual activities with your students? And what can be done to stop this from happening in our schools? So let's see your responses. And Seth Nakote says, our teachers the only culprit. I thought this cuts across all professions and sectors. It's bad for teachers to engage in such immoral acts, and they should desist from such acts. Teachers should also be well paid for them to afford dating matured ladies, really. And people always buy inferior goods because that's what they can afford. Let's give it a thought. You're saying, so you're asking us to think about the fact that, you know, teachers are not the only culprits and blah, 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 blah. I'm not sure people accept your response though. But poverty and vulnerability are the sole causes. The MPs should use their common fund wisely in order to create job opportunities for the vulnerable parents, in order to empower them financially. That will enable them to take care of the awards. God is watching. And Carl says they will not stick to bribery and corruption allegation leveled against them. Rather, okay, but what you're talking about is true, and so it needs to be talked about. And Kofi Bedu says this problem has existed since Adam. Some sitting MPs of parliament have either married your students or had affairs with your students before. As morality continues to degenerate, what should we expect? The act should be punishable with stiffer punishments. And David Kwashi says, do I remember a teacher saying at the time that it is his bush allowance? Well, what happened to the particular teacher? I hope he wasn't just told to go home and sin no more. If a lady student, okay, so I guess that's all time will afford us here on Joy News Interactive. We have a video to show you, but I'll be gone by the time you're seeing it. My name is Ms. G, the Entertainment General. I'll be back later in the evening on the Joy News Prime with Entertainment. Have a great day, but do well to visit the stand at the Accra International Conference Center. It's the Joy FM Beauty and Bridal Fair 2017. I was a bride in 2015. I'll still be there. Catch me there. Have a good morning.